الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليذر على دين كل وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. People react differently to calamities. People have levels. Some they become distressed and get destroyed because of the calamity. Some they stay stable. Some they lift up from these type of calamities. And one of the calamities and turbulence is knowing that someone out there is plotting and wants to do a damage to you, or he has already done a damage. This is one of the wickedest one. Today, I went and met a brother who his father-in-law is the one who is behind all the plots. He's doing black magic on him. And he has sihrul madfoon. This is why I decided to compile a video about Sihr al-Madfoon. Sihr al-Madfoon is black magic which has been buried. This is one of the wickedest magic. Trust me, by Allah. Magic was created by Allah Rabbul Izzah. Magicians were created by Allah Rabbul Izzah to do evil on the people. Now, if they have done that evil, and you know that the evil is upon you, the only way forward is through the sunnah. And you're holding tight upon the rope of Allah Rabbul Izzah. Because Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, وَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Hold tight to the rope of Allah Rabbul Izzah. Now, when you've been hit by a spiritual disease, don't despair and start looking for cheap alternatives. No, don't. Hold tight. Call upon the one who created the magic, who created the magician, the one who's superior, the one who created the evil that you are suffering from. Call upon that and you will achieve success. You will achieve contentment. Because one of the most important things is when you have the contentment through the calamity. This is very, very important. But if you have no contentment through the calamity, you will suffer. I personally have seen people going around the world looking for cure, and they come back and telling me, "Ya Sheikh, nothing out there." And in the first instance, I've already warned them, you're going to go around and you'll come back. Why? Because this person, you can see clearly, black and white, he's not engaged in upon calling upon Allah, Rabbul Izzah. He's engaged on what? Getting quick and rapid cure. This is a very wrong concept. When you are in calamity, again, I repeat, ask Allah to give you contentment in that situation, in turbulence, in calamity time. And then you will move forward. As for the jinns, jinns have no superiority. Jinns are the most wicked creation. Because once the slave of Allah, the son of Adam, becomes high in ibadah, in worship on Allah, he becomes higher than the angels. This is what needs for you to have it in your heart so that you move forward from this calamity you are in. The one who's watching this video, whether you are in a calamity of possession, jinn possession, black magic, evil, whatever the calamity is, ask Allah to give you contentment. Because Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَسْيَصْبَرْ. The one who fears and be patient. Because patient is very important. And fear of Allah is very important. You combine these two, you get contentment. And you get rewarded by Allah Rabbul Izzah. Now today I'm going to talk about Sihrul Madfoon. Because it's one of the most wickedest. He puts the individual down, trust me, by Allah Rabbul Izzah. They bury in your house, feed you, and then bury in the grave. And then all these comes with a jinn. Jinn protecting the magic in the grave, which has been buried. Jinn protecting the magic which has been buried at your own house. Jinn protecting the magic which is in the stomach of you. Now, that is a task. And this task is only one way forward, calling upon the superior, the entity which is strong, Allah Rabbul Izzah. Sihr Madfoon is one of the most wickedest magic, black magic of Barid. And these jinns are wicked jinns, wicked, because they love evil and they love to do evil. They are masters of evil. They will do the job sincerely. Now, what are the reasons behind this magic? The envious person goes to the magician. Either you are successful and he's not successful. Either you got a car. Either you got a beautiful wife. Either you got a beautiful shop or beautiful house. Then he wants to cause destructions. And he goes to a magician and represents something which belongs to you. If he doesn't have that, then your name. Once they have your name, the high rank from the magician does whatever he does. And then he get buried. And he get buried in the house. And now the burying in the house can be done by the jinns themselves, by Allah. Or other person could come and sneak in and bury it. Ask Allah to protect the believing men and women. Now this magic comes with symptoms. And the symptoms are always three. During the day, during the night, and during the time of ibadah, reading the Quran and salah. Now, if you achieve on one sign, you excel, the two signs, you will destroy it by the will of Allah. The night, you will have a peaceful night. The day, you will have a peaceful day. When you excel in your salah and your qiraatul Quran, reading the Quran in a bandut, this will become a task, will become a mountain. The individual will struggle because sometimes this sihr madfoon comes with a wicked jinn, a kafir who is staunch in his kufr and evil. And he will try so hard to protect himself and to stop the individual from doing ibadah. Because once you start doing the ibadah, you will start weakening him. We go back to hadith of Abdullah bin Mas'ud, that if the person elevates himself in the ibadah, the shaitan becomes weak. Hadith is long, I'm just taking brief. If you have these signs, know that you've been hit by black magic of being buried. Pins and needles all over the body, part of the body dead, you'll always feel dead. The individual will wish to die because of burying the sihr there. His name, his pictures were buried. Having suicidal thoughts in abandon. Losing hope in life, pain in the back of the head there a lot. The individual will hate to pray. The individual will hate to do any salah or anything to do with the deen. The individual will be afraid to sleep because every time he sleeps, he dreams of him being buried or is him being in a box or him digging a grave or digging some. The individual will have sickness after sickness, different type of sickness. The individual will have blood pressure problem. Sihr madfoon is bad. Now, how to move forward? Number one is call upon Allah, isti'ana, seek refuge towards Allah, Rabbul Izzah. Two, push yourself to pray 5 times. Adhkar morning, evening. Read Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Takathir, Surah Al-Fajr, Surah Al-Buruj, Surah Al-Baqarah. I repeat, Surah Al-Takathur, Surah Al-Fajr, Surah Al-Buruj, Surah Al-Baqarah. 4 surahs together. Read it on the water. Drink the water. Shower with the water. And sprinkle your house. Sprinkle your garden with this water. It could be they buried in your garden. It could be they buried in your house. So read it twice a day if you can. In abundance, and read it on the olive oil. Burn scent in your house. Bakhur, Luban, burn it. I'll leave a link, inshallah. And get Ruqya done on you. By Allah, get help from experienced Sheikh. If you already had, then carry on with that Sheikh to help you. And by the will of Allah, to remove this calamity, because it is a calamity. Black magic of being buried, it is a calamity. Now, if there's any question or anything, drop me an email, inshallah, and be patient. Because I will answer by the will of Allah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.